A major milestone has been achieved on Monday when it comes to American missile defense efforts. A ceremony at the Clear Space Force Base, south of Fairbanks, celebrated the end of construction and installation of a new Long Range Discrimination Radar, or LRDR, a sophisticated sensor. The Missile Defense Agency, in a press release, stated, "Once fully operational, LRDR will provide unparalleled ability to simultaneously search, track, and discriminate multiple small objects, including all classes of ballistic, and in later iterations, hypersonic missiles, at very long ranges, under continuous operation." In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how the U.S. has bolstered missile defense capabilities with a new radar. Let's get into the details. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play military vehicle combat game, War Thunder. We talk a lot about military vehicles on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? In War Thunder, you can choose from more than 1,200 playable vehicles from the 1930s to the 1990s and go to battle on more than 80 theaters of war. You can fly aircraft, helicopters, drive tanks, and command ships of all types and sizes, which have been carefully recreated from their real-world counterparts. It's available as a free download on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. So grab your friends and give it a try. All viewers of Defense Updates that register using the link in the description below will also get a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time as a bonus. LRDR is a gallium nitride, GaN-based, solid-state, active electronically scanned array, AESA, early warning radar that allows for continuous coverage, even when it's undergoing maintenance. The radar consists of individual solid-state radar blocks that can be combined to scale up the size of the radar. The multi-purpose GaN device used on the prototype version of the LRDR is from the Japanese electronics company Fujitsu, according to Lockheed Martin. The advanced radar is installed inside a newly constructed facility that's almost 5 stories tall. A testing and training phase will begin, and the sensor is expected to be fully integrated and operational by 2023. Once testing is finished, control of the radar will change from the Missile Defense Agency to the U.S. Space Force. The price tag for the LRDR's installation is around $1.5 billion. The LRDR will not replace the network of long-range radar stations across Alaska, which since the Cold War have been in place to monitor for encroaching aircraft and long-distance bombers. The LRDR is a multi-mission, multi-face sensor having a wide field of view. Notably, each of the massive arrays measures 60 feet high by 60 feet wide. Advanced gallium nitride technology makes this radar more sensitive and reliable than currently available radars. Once operationally deployed, the radar station, operating in S-band frequencies, will provide unparalleled ability to simultaneously search and track multiple small objects, including all classes of ballistic missiles at very long ranges. LRDR is powerful enough to identify lethal incoming objects, such as missile warheads, allowing the U.S. to launch interceptor missiles to take them down. LRDR features a scalable, open system architecture designed to mitigate future threats. The radar can be scaled and extended to counter evolving threats without changing the underlying hardware design. Additionally, the MDA said the long-range radar will also support space domain awareness by monitoring satellites orbiting the Earth, detecting, tracking, and identifying active or inactive satellites, spent rocket bodies, and fragmentation debris. MDA will integrate the radar into the Ground-Based Mid-Course Defense System, GMD, and the Command and Control, Battle Management and Communications, C2BMC, system during 2022 in preparation for formal operational acceptance by the U.S. Air Force in 2023. Lieutenant General A.C. Roper with the North American Defense Command said, "You have built an extra set of keen eyes that will paint the picture of any threat coming our way." After the brief ceremony, military officials held a roundtable with media calling in from around the country. Vice Admiral John Hill of the U.S. Missile Defense Agency said about the LRDR, "The primary driving requirement is against the ballistic missile threat. That is what the radar filters are designed to go after." Hill added that it's unlikely there would be additional hardware necessary for the LRDR to be reconfigured for tracking hypersonics in the future. Lieutenant General David A. Crum, who's in charge of Alaskan Command, the 11th Air Force, and Alaska's NORAD assets, including the radars that feed information back to bases in the lower 48, said, "Alaska gives us a field of view we need to do homeland defense," indicating that radar was specifically put in Alaska because of its vantage over the Indo-Pacific, which allows it to detect an ICBM launched from a vast area. Crum added the new capabilities are a complement to the existing radar systems. For the protection of the U.S. mainland, GMD, or Ground-Based Mid-Course Defense, has been deployed. GMD, Anti-Ballistic Missile System, has been developed with an aim to protect against incoming missiles by engaging them during the mid-course phase of ballistic trajectory flight in space. GMD has Ground-Based Interceptor, GBI, which carries an Exo-Atmospheric Kill Vehicle, EKV, that's designed to collide with the incoming missile to destroy it. Current sensors include ground-based radars, GBR, upgraded early warning radars, forward-based X-band radars, FB-XB, such as the sea-based X-band platform, and the AN-TPY-2, all developed by Raytheon. LRDR will strengthen this detection capability and hence will be a major boost to American missile defense efforts.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.